and post it any one student mentioned in the chat box. Are you able to hear my voice clearly? Any of the student can mention in the chat box.
No, ma'am. Ma'am, your voice is not coming clearly.
Beta, I said you have to mention in the chat box. Okay, you don't have to speak in between.
It's not clear.
Just keep your mics muted. Keep your mics muted, then you will be able to hear me clearly, okay? Don't disturb the class. I will remove you from the class now. Okay, so now we will be starting with chapter Safety and First Aid. Chapter number 6, Safety and First Aid. So what all we have to study in this is how we have to take safety from accidents, how we can be safe from accidents, and in case of accidents, what all first aid can be taken. So this all we will study in chapter number 6, Safety and First Aid. So now, as your first topic, you can see in your book is avoiding accidents. So first we will study about what accidents are. Switch off your mic, everyone. Okay, so we will study what accidents are. So first thing that we have to switch off your mic, I said. So first thing that we will study is what accidents are. So accidents can occur anywhere at any time. So accidents, they can occur anywhere at any time. The accidents happen suddenly and may cause injuries. The accidents, they can happen anywhere at any time. And they cause injuries. They are sudden reactions. Okay, they can happen suddenly and they cause injuries. So where all we can face accidents? We can face accidents at home, in school, and in playground. So these are the places where we can face accidents. They can happen anytime. So we must be careful in order to avoid accidents. If we don't want accidents, we have to be very careful. Switch off your mic. Don't say good morning in between. I don't need your good morning. So accidents can occur anywhere at any time, and they happen suddenly, and these accidents can cause injuries. These can cause at home. We may face accidents at home. At school and in playground. So accidents can occur any time. They can occur any time. We must be careful in order to avoid accidents. We must be very careful in order to avoid accidents. Now we will move to the next part. What all steps we have to come across when we deal with any kind of emergency? If there is any emergency, what all things we have to take care of? First is stay calm and do not panic. We have to be very calm. We don't have to panic. मतलब हड़बड़ाना नहीं है, शांति से काम लेना है. ओके, इन केस ऑफ एनी इमरजेंसी यू शुड कॉल अडल्ट इमीडिएटली, यू शुड कॉल आवर पेरेंट्स इमीडिएटली इफ देयर इज एनी इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन. कॉल अ डॉक्टर और एन एम्बुलेंस, यू शुड स्ट्रेट अवे कॉल अ डॉक्टर और एन एम्बुलेंस. Before the doctor arrives or an ambulance arrives, we should give first aid to the patient. So these are the four methods that we have to follow to deal with any emergency situation. मतलब एकदम से अगर कोई situation आ रही है, so how we have to deal with that situation? We have to stay calm. We don't have to panic. In case of emergency, call the adult immediately. Call your parents and or any of the adult near you. Call a doctor or an ambulance. You should call a doctor or an ambulance. Give first aid to the patient. Before the doctor arrives, we should give first aid to the patient. So these are the steps that we have to follow in emergency situation. Now we will move forward. So what is first aid? What is first aid? So immediate help given to injured person before the doctor arrives is called first aid. So how you can underline this in your book, those who have the book. Immediate help given to an injured person before the doctor arrives is called first aid. So what is first aid? Immediate help means immediately when we give help to the injured person before the doctor or an ambulance arrives, that is known as first aid. Now we will move forward. In case of minor cut, first topic you can see in your book is minor cut. In case of minor cut, what all you have to do? See, the first thing is that the cuts can cause infection by germs. See, germs infect any of the cut, and if there is any minor cut, the germs will attack that part and they can cause infections. So what we have to do? We have to clean the area with water and disinfectant. So what is disinfectant? Like Dettol liquid that comes. Okay, the brown color liquid of Dettol that comes, that is the disinfectant. Means it will stop the infection. So what we have to do, we have to clean the area with water and then we have to apply any disinfectant, means the liquid that cleans the infected area. Then put clean cloth to stop the bleeding. If there is bleeding, you have to put clean cloth to stop the bleeding. Now, what we have to do, we have to put any antiseptic creams, the creams that stop the growth of germs. We have to put antiseptic cream and cover that area with bandage. So these are the precautions that we have to take in case of minor cut. Infections, they can cause germs. And you have to clean the area with water and disinfectant. After cleaning, put the clean cloth to stop the bleeding and put antiseptic cream and cover that part with bandage. So this is the first aid that you have to do in case of minor cut. Now, what you have to do, you can see in this chart clearly. First aid for minor cut. First aid for minor cut. So what you all have to do, first you have to stop the bleeding. You have to stop the bleeding. Then clean the wound with water or disinfectant. Then apply any antibiotic or antiseptic cream. Then we have to cover the wound with any clean cloth or the bandage. So these are the first aids for cut. In case of cut, these are the first aid, the steps for first aid that we have to follow. Now we will study further. Now, what is tetanus injection? This injection, you can see, this is the tetanus injection. So when is this tetanus injection given? See, tetanus injection might be required if the skin gets cut by dirty or rusted object. If you are getting cut by dirty or rusted, rusted means jung lag jata hai jisme. Okay, जिसमें जंग लग जाता है, the brown layer वो आ जाती है उसमें. Okay, if you are getting the cut by dirty or rusted object, then it causes infection. Then that causes infection. So to avoid the infection, this tetanus injection is given. This tetanus injection is given when you get a cut by dirty or rusted object. And to avoid the infection, tetanus injection is given. So these were some of the first aid methods that you have to follow during minor cut. If you are getting cut, chota sa agar cut lagta hai, so these all things you have to follow. Now you can see in the picture in your book that is given, minor cut. So how this baby is crying, he is having minor cut, and see how is he crying. So this pains a lot. The minor cuts he got over here, it pains a lot. So before going to the doctor, we can provide the following first aid that we studied. You have to wash it with water. You have to apply disinfectant. Then you can apply bandage. So these are the first aid methods that can be followed in case of minor cut. Now we will move further. Now the second type of you will see is nose bleeding. Nose bleeding. Khoon aata hai naak se. Okay, that is nose bleeding. So what all things you have to do in case of nose bleeding? Ask the person to sit upright, means that person has to sit straight. That person has to sit straight. Pinch the nose, then we have to pinch nose ko dabana hai uske. Okay, to stop the bleeding, we have to pinch the nose ko daba ke rakhna hai uske. And what you have to tell is, you have to tell the person to breathe through mouth and not through the nose. That person whose nose is bleeding, that person should be told that you have to breathe, means you have to take air through your mouth and not through your nose. And during nose bleeding, the person should never blow the nose. Okay, you should never blow the nose. Jaise apan muh se saans chhodte hai na, waise apan ko naak se nahi chhodni hai in case of nose bleeding. So that person should sit straight, and we have to pinch the nose of that person, and that person should be told that you have to breathe through the mouth and not through the nose, and that person should never blow the nose. So these are the steps of first aid that we have to follow during nose bleeding. Now we will move further. We will study with the help of chart what first aid method for nose bleed we have to follow. Help the person to sit straight. We have to say that person has to sit straight. pinch the nose. We have to pinch the nose using index and thumb finger. Ask them to breathe through their mouth. That person should be advised to breathe through their mouth. Okay, so these all methods we have to follow during the nose bleeding. The person should be able to sit straight. You have to pinch the nose and you have to advise the person to breathe through their mouth. Now we will move further. You can see in the picture given in your book, the boy's nose is bleeding. The boy's nose is bleeding. So these all steps have to be followed during the nose bleeding. What all first aid steps I taught you just now, that steps have to be followed if you see any of your friend or any of your relative facing this problem. Now we will move further. The next page, number 64, your next topic is broken bones and sprain. What has to be done in case of broken bones or sprain? So first we will study is what broken bone is. So a break or a crack in a bone is called fracture. So what is fracture? If you get a break or a crack in a bone, if your bone breaks or cracks, that is known as fracture. So what you have to do, what all first aid you have to do, you have to place the person comfortably. Means the person whosoever's bone is fractured, you have to place the person comfortably. Do not move the fractured part. If any of means if the leg is fractured, so what you have to do is you don't have to move the leg. Do not try to straighten the fracture part. ऐसा नहीं कि खुद ही डॉक्टर बन गए, ठीक है, और पैर को सीधा इधर करने लग गए. It can damage. It can cause more injury. It can cause more pain. So you don't have to move the fracture part at all. And ask an adult to tie a splint. So now we will study what splint is. So in what is a broken bone called? It is called as fracture. So what all you have to do in case of fracture? You have to place the person comfortably. You don't have to move the fractured part. And you should not try to straighten the fracture part. And after that, you should ask an adult. Matlab mummy, papa ya koi bhi bada ghar pe hai. You have to ask that adult to tie the splint. Now we will study what splint is. So these are the steps for fracture. First aid steps for fracture. You can see this is the splint. This is the splint. Matlab jaise plaster banta hai na, that plaster is the splint. Switch off your mic, everyone, beta. Okay, good students. Okay, so now we will study further. See, you can see this is the splint. This is the splint. Jaise plaster bandhte hai na, usi ko bolte hai splint. So a splint or a sling support the fractured bone. So what is the function of this splint? It supports the fractured or the broken bone. Now, how you can make the temporary splint? मतलब थोड़े time के लिए कैसे बांध सकते हैं? पक्का तो plaster बांधता है doctor. Okay, so at home what you can do is you can make it using cardboard or old newspapers and magazines. So cardboard or old newspapers can be used to make a splint. Now, what is the function of this splint? This restricts the movement of the injured part. Means the injured part stops moving when we tie splint. When we tie the splint, the injured part stops moving. So it will cause less pain. It will cause less pain. Now we will study further. What is a sprain? What is a sprain? So sprain usually occurs when tissues around a joint are dislocated or torn. कई बार क्या होता है चलते चलते पैर मुड़ जाता है. So what causes? It causes sprain. It is sprain. जब एकदम से twist हो जाता है पैर या any of the body part, it causes sprain. और sprain में क्या होता है swelling occurs in affected area. The part in which sprain has been caused, in that part swelling occurs. सूज जाता है. ठीक है. What you have to do in case of sprain, use ice pack on the area till the swelling goes down. You have to use ice on that affected area. Make the patient rest and keep the area unmoved. You don't have to move the part. Okay, you have to make it still. उसको रोक देना है, rest करने को बोलना है patient को. Now, switch off your mic, beta. Switch off your mic, everyone. Okay, good. So, you can see in this picture what sprain is. See, you can see this area, this red area has swelling. So, this is what happens when any of the part, it gets twisted. So, swelling comes. So, what this boy is using? He's using ice pack. So, this ice pack will reduce the pain. So this is what you have to do in case of broken bones, means in case of fracture and in case of sprain. Now we will study what you have to do in case of light burn. Agar jal jata hai thoda sa, so then what you have to do? So first thing that you have to do is run cold water over the burn. If you get your finger burn, what you have to do? You have to pour the cold water on that affected part. You don't have to touch the blisters. Blisters kya hote hain? Chhale pad jate hain. Jab jalta hai to kya ho jata hai? Chhale pad jate hain. So you don't have to touch the blisters. If the blisters rupture, then wash the area with clean water and apply antiseptic cream. Agar wo chhala phat jata hai, if the blisters rupture, then you have to wash the area with clean water and apply antiseptic cream on that part. So this is what you have to do in case of light burn. Thande pani se dhona hai usko. Then you don't have to touch the blisters. And if the blisters rupture, phat jata, then you have to wash the area with clean water and then you have to apply antiseptic cream on that. Now we will move further. So see, you can see with this chart, first aid for burns. What are first aids we have to do in case of burns? Cool with running water. Thanda kar lo usko running water. So you can see this image. Okay, then cover that burn and call if any emergency situation. So these all methods, first aid methods you have to use in case of burns. So what you all have to do, you have to run the area with water. Then you have to don't have to touch the blisters. If the blisters rupture, clean that with water and apply antiseptic cream on that part. Now we will move further. What you have to do in case of an insect sting? Agar koi keeda kaatta hai, to what you have to do? Remove the sting from the skin with the help of sterilized, means clean forceps. Sting matlab dunk hota hai, theek hai? Dunk. कीड़ा डंक मार के जाता है. सो इन केस ऑफ दैट यू हैव टू यूज द क्लीन फोर्सेप्स. छोटी सी चिमटी जैसी आती है, दैट यू हैव टू यूज टू टेक आउट दैट स्टिंग फ्रॉम योर स्किन. सो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू स्टेरिलाइज. यू हैव टू स्टेरिलाइज द फोर्सेप्स. स्टेरिलाइज मतलब क्लीन करना. आपको पहले क्लीन करना पड़ेगा फोर्सेप. सो हाउ यू विल क्लीन दैट? यू हैव टू हीट द फोर्सेप्स and then you have to cool it. You have to heat the forceps and then you have to cool that forceps. okay? Then what you will do? You will apply petroleum jelly. Petroleum jelly matlab vaseline. You have to apply petroleum jelly or oil on that affected area. So these are the methods that you have to take care when an insect sting. Agar koi insect kaat raha hai, to what you all have to do is pehle to dunk nikalna hai. So for that you have to use clean forceps. Clean karne ke liye, first you have to heat the forceps and then you have to cool it. After that you have to apply petroleum jelly or vaseline on that part. Okay, now we will move further. Now you will see what is a wasp and a bee sting, what all you have to do. So the basic difference between wasp and a bee is madhumakhi. We call in Hindi bee madhumakhi, and wasp is tatayya. Switch off your mic, beta. Wasp is tatayya, that you call it as tatayya in Hindi. Okay, so in case of bee sting, you have to apply a paste of baking soda or toothpaste. If a bee stings, if madhumakhi, that you call in Hindi, if that stings you, what you have to do is you have to apply baking soda or toothpaste. And if the wasp stings you, then you have to apply vinegar or lemon juice. Vinegar is sirka that you use in Chinese products. When you make Chinese and all, you use sirka on that. So you have to use vinegar or lemon juice in that case. Okay, we will move further. See, you can see in your picture an insect sting. See this boy, he is stinged by an insect, so he is having so much of pain. So this is all what you have to first aid methods that you have to use in case of insect sting. Now I will teach you what you have to do in case of animal bite. So first thing that you have to do is you have to wash the affected area, means the area in which any animal has bited you. You have to wash that area with detergent and water. Wash that area very, very, very cleanly. Okay, then apply antiseptic cream and cover the wound. Jo bhi wound hua hai, you have to apply that antiseptic cream and you have to cover it. And you have to consult the doctor immediately. You all know that in case of animal bite, injection lagai jate hain. So you have to consult the doctor immediately and you have to take that injections. So this is what you have to do when an animal bites you. So what you have to do is you have to wash the hands and clean the wound to avoid the infections. You have to wash that area very clearly. Okay, so this is what we studied about first aid for various things: minor cut, for nose bleeding, for broken bones and sprain, for light burn, for insect sting, for animal bite. Now I can see some of the questions on my screen. So Pratyaksha, because splint is plaster, okay, the support that is given to the fractured bone. And Prathampal, we cannot put salt, beta. Koi bhi cheez agar jali hai, usme namak lagaoge to kitna dikhega. You don't have to put salt in case of light burn. Okay. Now, if anyone is having that in doubt in that much part, you can mention in the chat box. And if your chat box is not functioning, then you can message in the WhatsApp. Blister ka matlab chhale hota hai, beta. Chhale par jate na paakhi, that is okay. Chhale, yes, very good. Okay, so now we will move further. What is first aid? Abhi tak to padh liya, this all first aid you have to do. Now, what is first aid box? We will study about first aid kit or the first aid प्रत्यक्ष स्टेरिलाइज मतलब क्लीन करना, क्लीन टू क्लीन इट प्रत्यक्ष. ओके नाउ वी विल स्टडी फर्स्ट एड बॉक्स. So first aid box is the one that contains all the necessary things that are required for providing first aid to the patient. Now what all things we require to the give first aid, that all things are kept in this first aid kit or first aid box. Okay, now what all things does this first aid box contains? What all things are there in first aid box? So you can see in these things, many things are there. Okay. Now from the book, what all things are there in your book given? Scissors. Scissors are present in first aid box. Bandages are present in first aid box. Band-aids are present in first aid box. Okay, antiseptic creams are present in first aid box. You can see this antiseptic creams. Okay, cotton is present in first aid box. Crepe bandages are present in first aid box. Pain relief ointments are present, means dawai dard ki dawai jyoti, that are present in first aid box. You can see this cold pack. In case of sprain, we can use this cold pack, ice pack. Okay, so these are the things that are present in first aid box. So first aid box is the box in which all the things are kept that are required to give first aid to the person. Now this box contains scissors, bandage, band-aid, antiseptic creams, antiseptic liquids, cotton, crepe bandage, and pain relief ointment. Ointment matlab gel jo dawai hoti, tube that you have. Okay, jaise move ka hota hai na, move ki tube hoti, iodex balm hota. So these are the ointments. Switch off your mic, everyone. Good. आर्यन ओझा, कंसल्टिंग मीन्स टू जाना, डॉक्टर के पास जाना या डॉक्टर से बात करना. ओके दैट इज कंसल्टिंग. ओके सो नाउ वी विल मूव फर्दर. नाउ यू विल स्टडी व्हाट इज फायर इमरजेंसी एंड व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इन केस ऑफ फायर इमरजेंसी. So first of all, what is fire? So fire is very important. Switch off your mic. Who's this one? Switch off your mic, beta. Don't disturb in between. Okay, good. So fire, it is very important, but this fire can also cause accidents. If we don't handle this fire carefully, then it can cause accidents. So fires can be caused by oil, fires can be caused by electric gadgets. And what you have to do if a person catches fire? So what you have to take care of? Be prepared, be aware, and be ready. So these are the things that we have to keep in mind. You have to be prepared, you have to be aware, and you have to be ready. Okay, so now fire caused by oil. So what you have to do in case of fire caused by oil? Throw lots of sand over the fire. You can see this man, he's throwing sand in the fire, over the fire caused by oil. So in case of fire that is caused by oil, you have to throw sand over it. Reta fekni padti hai, okay? Use fire extinguishers to stop the fire. You can see this fire extinguisher. This is used to stop the fire caused by oil. And never use fire to extinguish the fire caused by oil. You should never use water. You should never use water. Extinguish means to stop. So you should never use water to stop the fire that is caused by oil. Why you don't have to use water? Because oil is lighter than water and it will float and it will spread further. Oil, it is lighter than the water and it will float on the surface, matlab teherega wo upar, and it will spread further. So you have to use sand and or you have to use fire extinguisher. You have to use sand or fire extinguisher in case of fire caused by oil. Now we will move further. What you have to do in case of fire caused by electric gadgets. Electric gadgets matlab electric ki koi bhi device hai. Gadgets means device. Gadgets means device. Okay. So what you have to do is you have to turn off the main switch and use sand or fire extinguishers. अगर घर में आग लगी है कोई भी इलेक्ट्रिक की चीज से, सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू टर्न ऑफ द मेन स्विच एंड देन यू हैव टू यूज सैंड और फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर्स एंड नेवर थ्रो वाटर, इट मे कॉज इलेक्ट्रोक्यूशन. वी विल स्टडी व्हाट दिस इलेक्ट्रोक्यूशन इज. ओके, इलेक्ट्रोक्यूशन इज द शॉक, इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक. इलेक्ट्रोक्यूशन मीन्स शॉक, इलेक्ट्रिक शॉक. इफ यू यूज वाटर in case of fire that is caused by electric gadgets, you may get electric shock. You can see this picture. This man is working on the wires, electric wires, and he is getting electric shock. So this is electrocution, shock. Now we will move further. Now if a person catches fire, then what we have to do? First thing that we have to do is you have to say that person to stop running. That person should not run. That person should be told to drop on the ground immediately. Turant let jane ko bolo. So drop on the ground immediately. Wrap a blanket around the person to cut off the oxygen supply. More the amount of oxygen, more the amount of fire. So what you have to do is you have to say that person to stop running. Then drop on the ground and then you have to wrap that blanket around the person and ask to roll on the floor. Roll karne ke liye bolo usko. Okay? So these are the three steps that you have to follow if any of the person or if your clothes catches fire. Stop, drops and roll. Stop, daudne se ruk jao. Drop on the ground and then roll on the ground. So in this way, you can stop the fire that is catched by your clothes or if a person catches fire. See, what you have to do is how you have to take care in case of fire. What all you have to do? Fire action. Do not panic. Hadbadana nahi hai. If you have the alarm button, press the alarm button. And if possible, call the fire brigade. If possible, then you have to call the fire brigade. Leave the building. You have to leave the building immediately. Leave the building immediately. Do not stop to collect your personal belongings. Koi bhi cheez padi hai ghar mein, uske liye rukna nahi hai. You have to leave the building. Do not use lifts. Use the stairs. Lift nahi use karni hai. Stairs use karni. CD se chalna hai. Lift nahi use karni hai. Okay, so these are the steps you have to follow in case of fire action if the fire is caused in your buildings. Now we will move further. Okay, what all you have to do is if the building is on fire, crawl to the exit door. Crawl karke exit door ki taraf jao. Okay, use the stairs. You should use the stairs. Don't use the lift in case of fire emergency. Keep a wet handkerchief. Handkerchief matlab rumal. Okay, or the towel on your nose and mouth. Nose ya mouth mein towel rakho, geela towel, so that the dhua jo hota hai na, the smoke that comes from the fire, that doesn't enter your body. And if there is no escape, if you are not able to move out of the building, then you have to stand near the window. You have to stand near the window, open the windows to allow the fresh air to come till the fireman comes to escape you. So these are the methods that you have to follow in case of fire emergencies. Now, thank you everyone for this beautiful session. If you have any doubt, you can mention in the chat box. If you have any doubt, you can mention in the chat box.